Hi, welcome. Let's talk rotations. I want to talk about how to identify the, not the leaders, but the laggards when it comes to stocks, cryptos, but in this case, sectors. And before I do, I just want to say thank you for joining and welcome. My name is John. And for some of you may know, I joined IBM back in 2015, and I was one of the very first on the blockchain team. I had two roles. I was the leader of the industrial sector. In my second role at IBM, I was the delegation holder. Why am I mentioning this? And why is this relevant? As the leader of the industrial sector, there was four industries underneath that hood, and one is oil and gas. So I'm familiar with the sector that I'm going to chat about, but also at the same time, I'm going to share several setups, just great setups in the oil and gas industry that fall under the energy sector. And as the delegation holder, the reason why I mention that is because I was the lead negotiator. So I would work shoulder to shoulder with our attorneys and the client attorneys to try to get these deals into the end zone. And all I worked on was the largest contracts. And so I'm very familiar with this space, not only that, with the blockchain space. The enterprise is getting blockchained up, which no one really knows, dating back to 2015. And in addition, I'm also a former co-founder of a Bitcoin and Ethereum futures hedge fund, and I was the core part of the architect of the setup for the fund. All right, hey, let's hop in. So what you're looking at here is I always have this running in the background. And there's 11 sectors, but unfortunately, TradingView only has room for 8 charts. And since I'm running out of real estate for this video, I thought I would just show 8 of the 11. I just wanted to share my concept. So in the upper left, as an example, we've got the consumer discretionary sector. And all of these, by the way, are 1 week timeframes. And then over here is the technology sector. We've got the consumer staples. And this is the energy sector that I actually want to chat about today. And then we've got the financial sector, which has taken a beating at time of recording, end of May. Most of you are aware about the debacle in those regional banks. And then this is the real estate sector. I want to keep a tight eye on that. And then the communication. This is what tipped me off to dig into the sector rotation is, as I was just glancing at this energy sector. And what I noticed was, is we've got some support. So this whole chart that you're looking at here dates back to 05. And I'll get out here because I know it's tough on the eyes. But when I look at this, what I'm seeing is we've got some level of support. And what this also tells me is we had a breakout, which broke above this support. So that piqued my interest. So now that my interest is piqued, I am in Coifin. This is one of my favorite financial sites. And we are looking at the energy sector. And it's the XLE. A little bit about this. There's 26 total holdings in this sector. And of the top 10 holdings, those represent about 74% of the total sector. As I was alluding to on that breakout on that previous, on the charts, this is the zoomed in view. And again, when I look at this and when I tighten it up, this is what really caught my, that piqued my interest. So right down here, we're dating back to right around 2003. And then for this peak right here, this is around 2014, 2015. So what is of interest to me is this whole move, right? We had an explosion to the upside, and where we've got this horizontal support is the neckline. So we've got this explosion and we've got price hanging out. What this is telling me is that we are basically building and accumulating for potentially the next to the upside. Just a quick minute here. I made a pit stop in Google Bard. I prompted it, what is the XLE symbol? And at a very high level, this fund invests in a basket of 25 large cap stocks, including ExxonMobil, Chevron, ConocoPhillips, and EOG Resources. And by the way, I've got charts on ExxonMobil, Chevron, ConocoPhillips, and probably 9 to 10 or 11 other, just what I'm seeing are beautiful setups in the making, and I'm excited to share that with you. All right, now we are back in CoinFin, and I want to just dig in a little bit more in terms of the waiting for the XLE. What do I mean by waiting? So if we look down, here are the ETF holdings. So here's the ticker for the holdings, the name of the security. Obviously, this is the energy sector, but it's this one right down here. It's the waiting. So if you notice, ExxonMobil is the heaviest weighted stock, XOM. And again, I've got a great chart on this. But ExxonMobil represents a little over 24% of the sector. And then Chevron, which I also have a great chart on this, this represents almost 20%. And then in third spot is the EOG resources. So basically, all of the other companies after the top two represent either 4.5% or less. But here's ConocoPhillips and then Schlumberger, who I negotiated a large blockchain deal with way back in the day. So I'm a huge fan of them, but they have it's a wonderful setup. Can't wait to share that with you. So that's a little bit about the waiting. So now let's hop into FinViz. And now what I want to try to do is just size up, where is this sector? Has it been a leader or has it been a laggard? And this is what I really enjoy about FinViz, is they've got these different time frames based off of the sector. So in this bar chart, you can see down here that energy, just a one-day performance, is just barely up over 0.03% on a one-week relative performance. Energy is down 1.32%, one-month relative performance. Energy's second to last, minus 5%. And on the 90-day relative performance, energy is still in second last at almost negative 7%. Half-yearly relative performance, energy is bringing up the rear at almost down 11%. And this is what's really encouraging to me, is it may be counterintuitive, but from a contrarian standpoint, I'm not really looking. Sure, there might be some swing trades or scalps by staying with some of these leaders. But I want to try to find something. It's always nice to find something where you've got a lot of momentum and you're finding it early. So this is what's encouraging to me is about energy. It's dead last on the half year. And then on a 1 year relative, it's down 8%. All right. So we're still in FinViz. Let's take a look at some technicals. So here's the XLE, and these are the daily time frame. And I've mentioned this before in a few prior videos, but this is really cool. If you're a pattern trader and a momentum trader, swing trader, FinViz provides these trend lines automatically. So we've got this top one right here, this purple one, and on the bottom, we've got this blue. But we've got this kind of compression wedge. And again, daily time frame. Now let's take a peek at the weekly. So down here to the left, I just love this trend on the weekly. So this tells me that we've got a nice trend, we've got some nice momentum, and we've got this little shelf building. So then let's go to the monthly. Let's zoom way out. This is what really piqued my interest, is right here. So if I can just draw a line to see some support right there. So if you see that, looks like we had a nice little breakout to the upside, and now we're just coming down and capitulating. So again, let me draw the trend line. So from a technical standpoint, I really like that. And then the moving averages, which are probably really faint, but we've got the SMA 20, 50, and 200, and we've got some bullish crossovers taking place. So from a monthly perspective, I'm very interested. And what this also tells me is that this move is not going to take place tomorrow. So it won't be a scalp. It won't probably be next week. If anything, it's going to take this some time for it to fully develop. But what I'm envisioning is probably end of summer, early fall. So right now, we are catching this early. We're still in FinViz, and I wanted to just take a little deeper dive, just learn more about this energy sector. There's 256 businesses in this energy sector. I stacked ranked the sector by market cap. So in first position is ExxonMobil at $427 billion and Chevron at $290 billion. And then we've got Shell bringing up third spot, Total Energies. Here's ConocoPhillips at $123 billion, and I've got a chart on that. Here's BP out of the UK, $103 billion. Got a great chart on that. So this is the makeup. I just wanted to size it up, see how many total companies were in this space. So now we're in stock charts. This is a really cool site too. This is the free version. And here is, we've got the XLE, and we are looking at the seasonality report. This little slide bar right here, we're going to go back 20 years. So all of these bars right here, this graph represents 20 years from a seasonality standpoint, okay? So if you remember, energy was on a tear. So here, from a seasonality standpoint, makes sense. Now, this is right here where we are at. This is May. So at time of recording, this is near the end of May 2023. So this is one of the lowest months for the calendar year. So then you can see June and July are nice uptrends, with the weakest month is August. But then it just stair steps its way up for the duration of the year. And then as we get back into January, it just keeps riding along. And from my experience, seasonality reports, they matter. So I'm a fan of these. Okay, this is my absolute favorite. So now that I'm interested, now I want to really take a deep dive, look under the hood, and see from a validation standpoint if we've got something. So this is stock charts. And again, this is called their RRG, relative rotation graph. And you can see up here in the symbols, I've got all of the 11 sectors baked in here so we can do the analysis. And we're benchmarking against the SPY or the S&P 500. And we're going to go back 3 years, and the time frame is weekly. There's four boxes. So in the upper left right here, it's called improving. And then the upper right is the leaders or leading. And then down here, the yellow section is weakening. And then the red are the laggards, lagging. And then down here, it's the same color codes. They represent the same for the four quadrants. And let me just play this and show you. By the way, I'm not going to go into too much detail on this just because of time, but there's several really great videos out on YouTube around this RG, and Stock Charts actually has some great ones they put out on this as well. So now let's just go back in time. So what I did is I slid this indicator all the way back 3 years, okay? So I'm just going to move it forward so you can kind of get a feel of what this looks like. And by the way, all of these sectors, everything rotates clockwise. So you can get a feel. We'll pinpoint where the XLE is, but if you can see what I mean. So right now, coming into 2021, XLI, XLB were in the lead. And then we've got XLY, XLK, XLC, they're weakening. We've got XLD, it's a laggard, but it's coming up into the improving section. And then we've got four over here, XLU, XLF, et cetera. And these are trending into the leading category. And then everything just cycles. So let's fast forward so you can see this. Now, let me just take a stop and let's find the, so here's the XLE down here. You can't see it. So we got to zoom out even more. There it is. So let me zoom out way out so we can find it. We can follow it. All right. So now I'm going to play this. Just keep your eye on it. So now it's in the laggards. So here it is right here. So we're still in 2022. And as it's coming up to the peak, remember, if you remember, energy costs were just going through the roof globally. So right now it's improving. And now it is a leader. Play it forward. Okay, so now I want to just really narrate. So here it is right here, and we're coming into 2023 right now. So here it is. So now I'm going to fast forward. We're going to go all the way till the end of the year, so keep an eye on that. So now we're moving out of the leading category into the weakening category. And we're heading over into the lagging category. We're almost to current date. So now we are at current date. So we've got a handful of sectors in this laggard. But what I love is we've got XLE right here. And I like the direction. So let's see as time goes by, as I mentioned too, next few weeks, next few months, let's watch this thing get into the improving category and ultimately into the leading category. But this is what I mean, how we can find them early and often is because of the RRG. So huge fan of that. So this is the sector returns from 2014 to 2023. And what I thought was very interesting is, as some of you are probably painfully aware or happily aware, but in 2021 and 2022, energy led the way across the sectors. And then currently year to date, it's bringing up the rear and second to last, just above financials. And then down here in 2018, 2019, and 2020, it brought up the rear for right here also in 2017, the four consecutive years, and then in 2015 brought up the rear as well as 2014. So what this tells me is that energy has been a laggard for years, and we may see this become one of the leaders based off of that RG here in the coming month. I'm in TradingView. Let's just walk through a few of the technicals, fundamentals. So here is a line chart on XLE, and these are live down here. So for example, for the last 6 months, this is really encouraging to me. XLE has been down 15%, year to date down 10, 1 year, almost down 10. But right here, this is interesting to me. So here is the COVID low right here. So this has been on a nice trend, a gradual trend to the upside. And right here, again, just the line chart, it looks like we've just been taking a nice deep breath, a nice correction, before we've got potentially another move to the upside. And then from a fundamental standpoint, here's some news. And as I was reading through this, I thought I'd call this out, but right here, Chevron to buy PDC Energy in an all-stock deal valued at a little over $6 billion at a premium of 11%. So what that tells me is that Chevron, they're going to pay a premium of 11%. They know what's coming. So that was encouraging. And then the rest, nothing really too exciting to call out. But anyways, from a fundamental news standpoint, TradingView makes it nice. It's all right here. From a technical standpoint, these are the speedometers, one of the best kept secrets in my opinion. And I remember, geez, 5-6 years ago when I first saw these, I'm like, there's no way. There's absolutely no way these are as good as what I think they are. And I won't go into too much detail on these. There's some great, TradingView does some great tutorials on this, but I'll paraphrase. So on the left are oscillators. Those are like the momentums, MACD, RSIs, things like that. And over on the right are the moving averages, which by the way, personally, I'm a fan of. And then the summary is aggregate sum of the oscillators and the moving average. There's also a multi-time frame view right here. So we got 2 hours, 4 hours. And then when I click on the one day, oscillators are a neutral and moving averages are a strong sell. So the summary is strong sell. That's encouraging. And then on the weekly, we got a little momentum to the upside, but oscillator sell, summary sell, everything is a sell, but right here, it's on the monthly. It's over here on the moving averages. So what this is telling me is that the moving averages might be picking up on some momentum to the upside. And remember, we're in that red quadrant, that lower left. So what this tells me is potentially 11 of the, there's 11 buys and 3 sells. So don't take this as serious or the gospel, but this sure is, once you do your own TA, I definitely use this as a kind of a guide, not a guidepost, but just something to be aware of. How about that? So this is XLE, and each of these candles represent 3 weeks. And this goes back to, looks like 99. And I drew in some support and resistance, which is this horizontal blue line. What I want to call out is that it looks like right here in about the GFC timeframe, 08-ish, we had this kind of aggressive move to the upside, but it got denied. So that's why I've got this blue line right here as now it's acting as overhead resistance. And then right here in 2011, 2012, it got rejected. Got rejected again in, looks like late 2012. But then right here, we had a move to the upside, broke through in 2013, hung out. Didn't last very long, broke through. resistance, resistance. But now we have, and by the way, this is the COVID low, and this is a V bottom recovery. And we have been hanging out here for a while now, almost a year and a half, maybe two. So this is basing. So when I look at this, this tells me that we are resting now on support, what used to be resistance. So let's add in, let's layer in a few indicators. And most people are familiar with the Bollinger Bands. So I'm going to take the time frame down from 3 weeks down to 2 weeks, just to illustrate my point. And then these Bollinger Bands are monthly time frame. So we've got a multi-time frame analysis going on. So we've got two-week candles and monthly Bollinger Bands. So here is the top of the band, bottom of the band, and this kind of turquoise line is the mid-band. If we zoom in, we've got price action resting literally right on top of the band. By the way, for some of you Bollinger Band fans, you probably know this, 95% of price action stays within the bands, either the top or the bottom. But when you see these price action, when it comes out of the band like this or like this, that means we're typically going to get a slingshot in the other direction. So we broke out right here. So this tells me this is our slingshot in the other direction. So am I sold on this from a technical standpoint? No, but it sure looks amazing. So let's throw on, just from a validation standpoint, if you remember that speedometer for the moving averages on the monthly time frame was a buy. So this is one of my favorite moving averages that TradingView has for free. And I like it because of the colors. If we just focus on the green and the green means strength and red means weakness. And when price is above green, time to be serious. And then when price is above the green, the strength, probably a time to consider going in. And I'm actually going to take this down, the moving averages down to a, take it down to 6 days. So I want to illustrate a point on the green and the red. So right here, we've got a lot of green. We've got a lot of strength. And what this reminds me of is down here. So we've got this thickness where it's being created, and it just has this nice run to the upside as well as here. Now, sure, we could actually have this happen where we're green and we just collapse. We're green, we collapse. But I'm optimistic about this because remember the Bollinger Bands, and this is now acting as what looks like to be support. So I'm a fan of that, so that indicator. And again, that's the EMA SMA ribbon in TradingView. All right. So that was a little bit about XLE. And so to me, I'm optimistic. Is that where I want to just place my bets and go all in on that symbol? No. So now what I want to do is to find more alpha to chase more yields. Let's take a look at the companies that make up the sector. I thought I would start with this beast just because it's a personal friend of mine when I was at in the old IBM days. But again, TradingView, and this is really cool. We've got future forecasts as well as another speedometer in terms of what the analysts are calling it. In this case, they're calling it a strong buy. There's 31 total analysts on this account. And from a future forecast on a low case of 24, mid case 47, on a high case of 69. So this right here, when I look at it, I'm optimistic. And now let's take a look at the technicals. And I won't go into too much detail on this because I have so many good setups coming. But this is textbook. So right here on this peak was in 2014. And we finally had this breakout here in 2022. You're going to see this pattern a lot for this video. But I call these BRBs. I've seen these so many times in trading. But this is literally a breakout, a retest, and a bounce. BRB, breakout, retest, bounce. So this is a beautiful, absolutely studly looking chart just from the technicals. Here is Occidental Petroleum Corporation, and this is another beautiful chart. And by the way, Oxy, O-X-Y, I did a video on this about a week or so ago, but Berkshire, Charlie and Warren, they double down on this particular stock. If I'm not mistaken, I think they own 15%, 20% now of Occidental Petroleum Company. And they bought right around here, those savages. So this is a really, from a technical standpoint, we've got this kind of this compression wedge. This is going to create a lot of volatility. And based off this setup, it looks like it's a high probability volatility to the ups. Here is BP, British Petroleum, out of the UK. And these are monthly bars. What I want to just call out right here, this right here acted as overhead resistance, and then broke out. So here is the beginning of our BRB. This is the breakout, this is the retest, and this is the bounce. So right here is a V-shaped recovery. Not only that, if you can see, we've got this flag. It's not quite out of the flag, but when this does break out, these are very bullish patterns with a high probability of a breakout to the upside. And again, remember, these are monthly time frames. So this could take a few months, but definitely something to keep an eye on. ConocoPhillips, we're still in trading view. And I wanted to share this with you. So here we are, we've got the analyst rating. There's 28 total analysts covering this. And of the 28, they're calling this a buy. And what I wanted to share with you is that none of the analysts are saying sell or strong sell. Everybody is saying hold, buy, and most of them are saying strong buy. And then from a future forecast, looks like they've got a low side of 94, current price is at 101, and then on the mid case at 132, and on the high case of 165. Now, this is why from a low case, I was skeptical about that, because when I look at this chart, this is so classic. I wish I could spend more time on this. This chart right here should be in like a technical analysis 101 first chart to look at, because it's textbook. So again, in the next few months, I fully expect this to a nice breakout to the upside. So as I go through these charts, I'm getting more and more confirmation that the sector, the energy sector, is going to move to the upside. Now, here's the big boy, Chevron. We've got the analysts, there's 27 of them, but 27 of them are saying this is a buy. Now, these are monthly candles, and right here dates back to right around mid, late 2014. So this right here acted as, we've got the horizontal overhead resistance, and then this whole section right here acted as overhead resistance, which was about a three-year period, give or take. So from around 2017 to 2020-ish. But what I'm really encouraged, by the way, so here is the COVID low, this V-shaped recovery, but it was an explosion to the upside. So now we've got this classic SR flip. So now this is support right here. And we basically flipped up through resistance. And now the resistance, high probability, will act as support. Not only that, but if you can see this, we've got the 1.618 extension to the upside, and I placed it right here on the swing pivot high, and on the low, I placed it right there. So that gives us the 1.618, and then right there is the 2.618. So Chevron, this is a classic chart, very nice looking chart. All right, so here's the big one for the sector as well as the industry, ExxonMobil. If I'm not mistaken, I think this was around $450 billion market cap. But right now, there's 28 analysts covering this, and they are saying it's a buy. And of the 28, only one is saying a sell. And I'd love to meet that person. But 13 are saying hold, and 14 are saying strong buy. So here is the future forecast. Current price at 104, mid, low case 110, mid case 127, high case 146. And when I look at the technical, if this horizontal support dicks, I see a nice move to the upside. So I won't go through this chart either, but technically speaking, this is just it's a beautiful chart, and especially if you look at my crosshairs. Actually, I'll just draw that real quick because I just noticed this. But this is in a beautiful horizontal channel, and then we've got this nice move, this breakout to the upside. So here's our BRB, breakout, retest, bounce. And this breakout occurred in October of 2022. So ExxonMobil is looking nice. Now let's move into Alliance Resources. So just a few seconds on this. Hopefully you're starting to see the trend on this. There are so many good setups, and it didn't take me long to find all of these. So the analysts are saying that this is a strong buy. And you can see the current price at $17, low case 28, mid case 29, and high case of 32. So let's take a peek at the technicals. And look familiar? Does this look familiar? So I won't go through that, but so here is the COVID low. Oops, excuse me. Here is the low, the V-shaped recovery we broke through. And this looks like now this support, which used to be resistance. So let's see if this sticks. And again, I would give this a high probability just by looking at this particular chart of what's in front of me. Antero Resources Corp. This is a buy. There's 19 analysts. And by the way, of the 19, only one is recommending a sell. And here is the chart. Absolutely beautiful. I had to take this down to the weekly because I wanted you to see the entire history. But another classic SR flip. And I fully expect this to be a breakout to the upside. And remember the BRB, breakout, retest, bounce. This is the federal debt, total public debt for the Department of Treasury for the U.S. And this goes back to the 60s. And the reason why I wanted to mention this just briefly is because the U.S. government just approved, I think it was over the weekend, to lift the debt ceiling. I think it was another $4 trillion. So currently we're at $31 trillion in change. And this will take the new, I'm going to take it up to 35, right around there. So that's about another 12% increase in our total debt. But the reason why I wanted to share this with you is that by increasing the debt ceiling, this is actually a good thing, a great thing for energy and all of these stocks. Now, this might be the most important chart that I have shared, and this is WTI crude oil. So this is what it's going to cost for oil, but also at the pump. This is very interesting to me. See, these are monthly time frames. And I've been working on this Elliott wave count now for, gosh, a couple of years. So I think this thing is pretty accurate. So this right here is in 08, the GFC. And the bull flag started in 04. So this thing is almost, 20 years, call it, in the making. But you can see we finally broke through in November-ish. Let's see. Yeah, in mid-2021. Okay, so remember the BRB? We got a breakout, we got a retest, and now what I'm waiting for is the bounce. But what I really want to call out is for those Elliott Wave fans out there, we're at the bottom of the second wave, and we're actually coming into a few different third waves. So for anybody that's watching this that knows Elliott Wave, if you want to examine my count versus your count, I'd love to know. But what I'm seeing is oil right now, it's at $69. Sure, it could go a little lower, maybe down to low 60s, 50s. But then eventually I see it going up around 265% to around $260 a barrel. Again, current price, 69. Forecasted price, 260. So I had to share this one with you. I've never heard of this company, but again, this is more validation confirmation that this energy sector is going to start moving. There are 30 analysts on this, and it's a strong buy. There's only one that says sell. 23 are all saying a strong buy. Let's take a peek at the technicals. I won't go into this, but this is beautiful. This is another classic case of overhead resistance now turning into what looks to be potential support. I love the volume down here for this double bottom. This tells me in the coming months we should expect a move to the upside. Alliance Resource Partners. Seriously, again, look at this. Here's another one. Strong buy. We've got a future forecast. Current price is 17. We've got a low case of 28, mid case 29, high case 32. Let's take a peek at the technicals. Look familiar. So I won't go through this, but just check this out. The volume is fantastic. This is record high volume for the entire history of this particular stock. But yeah, just textbook volume. This is exactly what we're looking for if we want to get confirmation that this will hold. So I give this another one high probability of a move to the upside. And I'm almost done, but I just want to show a few more setups. just to share with you, but also at the same time provide validation, Devon Energy. And there's 31 analysts covering this. Only one are saying sell, 14 are saying a strong buy. Here are the technicals. We'll go into detail. But again, this is the SR flip, but take a peek at the volume. A record high volume. Love it. EQT Corporation. This is probably one of the worst ones I've seen, but this is a buy rating. There are 25 analysts. And what I mean by worst, no one is saying sell. However, we do have a slight deviation from the current price. So the low case would be 7 cents less than what it is now. Mid case 44, high case 60. And then what I'm seeing is that we've got this little compression wedge, but I actually see this thing going up. Yeah, gosh, minimum to $60 and potentially, remember these analysts they're very conservative. But so yeah, I see this as a nice move to the upside over the next, say, 12, 18 months. And again, volume looks fantastic. This is the last one I had to share with you, just one more setup. This is unbelievable. So I've never heard of Console Energy. But again, strong buy, and you can see the future forecasts. And then here are the technicals. I just can't believe how beautiful this chart is. So we are in another compression wedge. Just make that a little bigger. Yeah, we are in another compression wedge scenario. And then right here, this acted as resistance. And then right here, we broke above it. So here's our BRB again. We got a breakout. We just retested right there. It's like we'll meander, but I fully expect this to do something like this. And that puts us, I didn't do any time or price-based analysis on this, of course, but gosh, in the next, 12, 18 months, I'm just taking an eye on this. So anyways, I hope that was helpful. This is the research I did. Hopefully you found some good setups. This is not financial advice. One of the main reasons I wanted to share this with you is I think costs are going to go up. Energy costs, which means heat, as an example, air conditioning. But at the same time, we're going to have gasoline going up as well. So just from a budgetary standpoint, this is part of the message I also wanted to share as well. And then in closing, I hope this was helpful on how to find stocks, assets. I didn't share any cryptos with you, but how to find the rotation. It's a fantastic tool to add in your trading tool bag. All right, thanks so much.